Yes, good evening, YouTube. Tonight, I want to tell you about the time that my buddy and I came pretty close to getting arrested. Not really, but sort of. All right. Probably not that close at all, but it's a good story. Unfortunately, my wife and I were already drinking wine tonight, and we killed the bottle, and I'm all out of wine. It's going to be tragic. I'm very sad. I wish I could say more wine. I need more wine. I don't have any wine. I guess there's a tiny bit. I don't know. This is a crisis. How the hell we ran out of wine? I don't know. Okay, I'm not totally. I'm kind of. I kind of. All right. All right. I'm lying a little bit. There's one bottle of wine left, but it's like a really nice wine that was given to us as a gift, and we didn't want to open it. So, need to go to the wine store probably tomorrow. But anyway, back to the story. Back to whining. All right. So this was back when. Oh, and by the way, I'm really nasally because the allergies are terrible right now, but. Anyway, so this is back when I was 16 years old. My buddy and I we had both just gotten our license recently, and back in high school, he had an old Ford Escort, and it was like a crappy Ford Escort. It wasn't very nice, but it was fun, and we were driving around. Anyway, one day he was driving both of us back to my house, and we're driving around and blah blah blah, and he's like, "Hey, check this out. I'm gonna make the tires squeal around this corner." And I'm like, "All right, cool. You know, yeah, that'll be cool because we're 16 and we can drive and we're making the tires squeal." So he like goes around the corner and yanks the wheel real hard and goes around the corner. And as we're in the middle of going around the corner squealing the tires, there's a cop right there, like three cars back and that like waiting for the stoplight. And we're like, "Oh shit, we're so fucked. Damn it. Need more wine." All right, so rounds the corner, tires squealing, cops right there. We know we're fucked. So he's watching the rearview mirror and he's like, "Oh yeah, the cops turn around, so we're screwed." So I'm like, "All right, I'm gonna get your insurance papers out." And he's like, "Yeah, they're in a glove box." I opened a glove box and a fucking huge, giant bag of weed falls onto the ground. And I pick it up and I'm like, "What the hell, dude?" And he's like, "Oh shit." He's like, "My brother drove my car like yesterday or 2 days ago, whatever. It must be his stash." And we're like, "Holy fuck, what am I gonna do with this?" Like, I'm like, so I quickly just throw it under the seat. And I'm like, "Oh my God, I can't believe." So we're both just freaking the fuck out. We've got this giant, like, fist, it's like a fist-sized bag of weed sitting under my seat. And we're like, "Holy shit, we're so screwed. What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? Good Lord, look at the size of that bird shit. Damn, I have to wipe that off my wife's car." So sad. Right, I must carry on the whining with Dan Torch because you need it. So, cops pulled up behind us, got the lights going. We stop, and we're both freaking out, and the cop comes up, and he's like, "Going a little fast around that corner, weren't you there?" And he was like, "Oh yeah, sorry. Like, I don't know this neighborhood very well, and my friend here was telling me," you know, pointing to me, "was telling me like directions, and he told me really late when to turn." And I'm like, "Yeah, sorry, officer. I totally wasn't paying attention. I didn't realize that this was our turn. I told him too late, and so he went late and it squealed." And the cop was like, "All right, well, next time just slow down." And he let us go. He didn't check like my buddy's license, he didn't check our insurance, nothing. He was just like, "All right, carry on." We were like, "Holy shit, are you kidding me?" So we immediately drove home. We're like, "Oh my God." And of course, Brandon, my buddy, calls up his brother and just fucking arena, like, "Dude, don't leave your fucking stash in my car. What the fuck is wrong with you?" Oh, it sucks so bad. We were so scared, man. We were about to piss ourselves. So the moral of the story, kiddos, don't fuck around if you got weed in your car. Well, unless you're in a state that allows it. But, you know, this was back in 1996 in Michigan. So, anyway. All right, well, it's a short story, but I thought it was a funny story. I was thinking about it the other day because of the video about being pulled over, and I was thinking about funny stories about being pulled over. This came up. So tell me some of your funny stories. You got any close calls with the cops that you got away with? Let's see them in the comments below. But in the meantime, if by some reason you haven't subscribed to my channel, you should by clicking right here. Maybe even watch this video. Consider giving me a thumbs up, share this video. You know, we'll be doing more car stuff, but in the meantime, stay awesome.